Is an irrational number different from a rational number? Think about this question during the lesson. The Venn diagram shows the relationships among rational numbers. A number that can be expressed as an integer or a ratio of two integers is a rational number. When expressed as a decimal, the decimal is either terminating or repeating. An integer is a positive or negative whole number or zero. Whole numbers are the positive integers and zero. Whole numbers have no fractional or decimal parts, and they do not include negative numbers. A natural number is a positive integer greater than zero. Negative numbers and fractions are not natural numbers. How would you classify the number 0.2475823 and so on? How can you use the definition of each number set to classify numbers? Is it a natural number? No. Decimals aren't natural numbers. The same is true of whole numbers and integers in general. Then maybe it is a rational number. Is the decimal a terminating decimal? How do you know? The number is not a terminating decimal. The three dots at the end tell us that the decimal goes on forever. We don't know what they are, maybe 5, 8, 3. But we do know that they are not repeating, nor are they all zero. So is the given number a rational number? It can't be. The decimal is neither terminating nor repeating. Numbers that are not rational are called irrational. An irrational number is a number that cannot be written in the form A divided by B, where A and B are integers and B is not zero. The number 0.2475823 and so on is irrational because the decimal expansion is non-repeating and non-terminating. Irrational numbers include non-repeating decimals, most positive and negative square roots and other roots, and special numbers such as pi. Suppose the decimal was written as 0.2475823. Would this decimal be a rational number?
Select your answer.
Now the decimal terminates, so it would be a rational number. It's 24,758,326 10,000,000ths. Now you know how the different types of numbers are related and how to classify them.
Classify each number as rational or irrational.
For sake of rewriting everything, I am just going to circle. So we're going to start with the rational numbers first. So the rational numbers would be negative 17, 3.275, and 0 and 76 hundredths. And the irrational will be this one, pi, and this one.
Classify the square root of 3.
Square root of 3 means the non-negative square root of 3. The square root of a number is a number that, when multiplied by itself, equals the original number. The radical symbol square root is used to denote the non-negative square root. Click on each square to reveal the information about the square root. So this will be 1 of 1 and 1. So the square root of 1 is 1. Then we have here 2 times 2 equals 4. The square root of 4 equals 2. Then we have 3 times 3. And you have the square root of 9, which is the total number of squares, equals 3. All right. So these are all perfect squares. And that is a number that is the square of an integer. The first three integer perfect squares are 1, 4, and 9. The number 3 is not a perfect square, so the square root of 3 cannot be written as an integer. So the square root of 3 is irrational.
Classify each number as rational or irrational. Explain how you classified each number. -81,572. The square root of 11. 5.63633633, and so on. The square root of 16.
All right, so off bat, I know this is irrational because it's a decimal that continues. It's not repeating, it just goes on. Square root of 11 is odd, and it's 11. So I know that that's not going to be a perfect square, so that's going to also be an irrational decimal. The square root of 16 will give us an integer, so that would be a rational number. And then the -81,572 will also be rational. And so here's more explanation. -81,572 is an integer and can be written as this fraction, so it's rational. Square root of 16 is a perfect square because it equals to 4, which is rational. 11 is not a perfect square, so it's irrational. And then this is decimal, as I said before, it doesn't repeat or terminate, it's irrational. All right, we need to classify each of these numbers as rational or rational. And I'm going to just use different colors by circling like I did before, just to save me rewriting these again. So 2/3, we'll start with the ones that are rational. So rational will be in purple. So rational would be the square root of 25. Another rational would be 7,548,123. And that's because it's, it's an integer, and the square root of 25 is a perfect square. It equals 5. Let's see. And negative 7,500 would also be rational because it's an integer. Repeating decimal. And then we have what's left would be, I didn't mean to erase it, but what is left is our irrational, which would be these two.